I have to assemble now the chain for the timing gears, front gear for the crank, and also the camshaft. This is a new chain. It is an open link chain. No play on the gear, even though it is not a new one. Also, we can make the same test for the camshaft gear, and there is no play. This is the open link. And after assembling, I have to determine the correct position of the camshaft and the crankshaft in order to make a correct timing, because when I have disassembled this engine, I suspected that the timing was not right. It was with one tooth in retard, and I know now how to determine the correct position. It is an old method that I have found also. It is the same method in the manual for R35 model, this model. I have to assemble the piston and the cylinder in order to determine the correct position of the timing for the gears. So, in order to determine the correct position, we need the piston to be at the top dead center, TDC, and we need the tappets inside here. In order to determine the position, as you can see, when you turn the camshaft, we see the tappets moving. So we have to put the camshaft in the position where the lobe of the camshaft are on the top. As you can see, when you move the camshaft, also move the tappets. So we have to put the tappets at the same distance. We determine that with the caliper. And we have now 13 millimeter and 0.2 millimeter, and on the other side We have 11 millimeters, so we have to move the camshaft. We have to lower this tappet. That should be okay. And now we have... No, it is not okay, it just moved. Now I think it is okay. So we have 13 millimeter. And on the other side, we have also 13 millimeter. So this is the correct position. Now we can read in the front. You see, this is an old mark. It was made to be here in order to be aligned with this one, but it was not. And like I said before, it was a difference of a tooth. So we have the piston on the top dead center, equal distance between tappets and the surface of the engine, and this is the correct position, and that means I just have to make a mark. For making a quick align, but after I will put the chain, I will measure again the distance for the tappets here inside.
Okay, it was not easy, but also not impossible. The engine is rotating on the right, and that means the chain is traveling like this, and you have to put the key in the right position. And this is the right position with the opening here, because the bolts here always will push in the key, and it will not fall. Now we have to rotate the engine, and after we are rotating the engine, we can verify if we have the correct timing for the gears. Tappets. Thirteen millimeter. That means we have the correct timing gear now. So we have the top descenter. The quick marks that I made for a quick alignment, and also we are checking again the distance between tappet and the surface of the engine. I have 13 millimeter, and we need to have the same distance here. And I have the 13 millimeter. So the tappets are at the equal height. We have the top dead center. The quick marks here. The link is assembled. And we have the chain and the timing gears ready. The next step is to assemble the front cover just for a test, and I have to determine the correct axle play, because it is very important, and I will explain why. On the camshaft we have the holes for the lubrication. If the axle play is too big, let's say like this, the camshaft will tend to go out because of the rotation of the chain, and the holes will not be aligned with the whole lubrication, and that means we will have oil for the front bush of the camshaft, but we will not have oil for the back bush of the camshaft and also for the cylinder head. So I will assemble the front cover, determine the correct axle play, that means 1 or 2/10 of a millimeter. I don't want to have an axle play bigger than this dimension, and I will show how to adjust this axle play. Now I will assemble the front cover for the timing gears. We have a new gasket. And I have to determine the axle play of the camshaft, and if it is too big, I have to lower the axle play.
Sorry for the music in the background, but today is Sunday and my neighbors are making a party, which is quite normal. So we have this axial play. It's not very big, but I will try to lower to reduce the axial play. We have a 1/4 of a millimeter. I would like to have 1/10 of a millimeter or maximum 2/10 of a millimeter. For doing that, I just have to press this bush. This brass bush is the friction bush for the axial play. So I have to press this bush inside just 2 or 3/10 of a millimeter. I have succeeded to reduce the axial play for the camshaft. Now I have only 1/10 of a millimeter, and that is perfect. I have to buy new bolts because the old one are worn out in the head. And after I will buy the bolts, I'll make the final assembly for this cover.